Sadero e de Mesua e Sobo e Messias arriba subia la Catia. Mishada la Soe Serendariata arrego e Suba in Balacarumenta. Veneto e Doseva in Labo e Saviata arraca Simaleatus. Se Suba e Shamito e Zeco e Cana Rome e Lodoria Palanego e Suba. La Hana arrogo e Suba. La Hani arrogo e You can choose this day to be your day of deliverance, to be your day of actual freedom in Christ Jesus. Rabasuani Gomelo Nibosia Taramanibo, Seolo Gerro Taria Nasiano, Alo Menero Nisuba de Sevena Pito, Alcaneso Nata Atara Kamasumeno Elebo, Elebuma Ikotoria Malakasia, Olo Kotoria. That is what we the day you choose freedom in Christ Jesus. That is what we the day that your name will be out of your lips. Rakuma Sia, Nakuma Ikomoria, Maelo, Maikuma Sosa. To give them up to the Lord, the only one who has answers, the only one who has solutions. God knows that we are not carrying water, and that you will actually not pick them up again. That you will actually not pick them up again. Time and time again, we come to the Lord with our burdens, and instead of leaving them, before him, instead of leaving them by his feet, when we leave, we pick them again and we go home with our burdens. May this be the day that you choose to give it to Jesus. May this be the day that you give it to Jesus. May this be the day that you do not pick it up, beloved, that you lay it before his feet and you say, Lord, I cannot do this by myself. I cannot get myself out of this debt by my own effort. I cannot get myself out of this addiction by my own effort. I have tried and I have failed this month. I need you to help me, Jesus. I need you to help me, oh Lord, that I may be able to overcome all my problems, that I may be able to overcome all my addictions, that I may be able to overcome everything that has come against my life to this day. Let this be the day that you lay it before the Lord. Time and time again, we get tempted by the enemy to pick up our problems and to try and come up with solutions after laying it before the Lord in prayer. Beloved, I'm here to tell you in this day, leave it before the feet of Jesus. Give it to the one who has the ability to do something about your situation. Today, you are going to hear the word of the Lord for your life. You are going to hear instructions from the Lord for your life. Going into 2022, these are some of the things that God is calling you to let go of, to leave before him and to allow him to be God in your life, in those situations. I pray for you, my friend, that you will be able to hearken to the voice of God, that you will not harden your heart in this day, that you will choose to be submissive to the Spirit of the Most High God, and you will allow him to be God in your life. You will allow him to do what only he can do in your life. Today we are going to pray for our hearts. Before we get into the word of the Lord, we are going to pray for our hearts. You need to pray for your heart, beloved. You need to pray for your heart. Our hearts are naturally stony and stubborn before the Lord, before the instructions of the Most High God. We are constantly at battle. We are constantly fighting against the ways of God in our lives. And yet, there is a contention within our members, because the spirit is drawn towards the ways of the Lord, because it knows that is the only place of refuge, that is the only place where solutions are found for your problems. It does not matter what the problem is. God, who made all things, knows all things. And God knew that you would be in that situation that looks like it cannot, or it does not have any solution to it. God knew that in this time in your life, the enemy would have you pressed against the wall. God knew that you would be in that situation where you feel like the only way out is to commit suicide. God knew that you would be in that situation where you think and you feel like the only way to make it is to be corrupt. God knew that you would be in that situation.
Amen.
But God has a helper for me and you.
Amen.
This helper becomes whatever we need whenever we need it.
Amen.
There is no situation above God, beloved.
Amen.
There is not a single situation that God cannot handle, that God does not have solutions to, that God does not have answers to.
Amen.
God knew everything that would transpire in your life before you were even born.
Amen.
God knew everything that would be required of you in this world before you were even deposited in this place.
Amen.
So God knew and God knows, and only God has solutions.
Amen.
Time and time again, as humanity, we are drawn to try to make things happen for ourselves.
Yes.
How long? How long are you going to play this game of trial and error when you can go into a path that has a surety of results?
Amen.
A path that you can be sure of what you expect in the end.
Amen.
How long, beloveds, are we going to live our lives by chance? We serve a God who knows.
Amen.
Where you are, and he meets you exactly where you are.
Amen.
I repeat, there is no situation that God cannot handle. There is not a single situation. It does not matter what it looks like. It doesn't matter how many people have given up on you. It doesn't matter how many people are telling you, you are done. There's no way you can recover from this. There is no situation that can be brought before God that God cannot get you out of. And not just get you out of it, but glorify himself through your life.
Amen.
I need you to be encouraged in this day. I need you to know that we serve a living God. God is not a motivational speaker,
mm-hmm.
beloveds. God is not a motivational speaker.
Yes, ma'am.
He doesn't just tell us things that tickle our ears, but that they're actually not going to be fruitful in our lives.
Yes.
He doesn't tell us things to tickle our ears and to make us feel better about ourselves, only to go back to the same dysfunctions that we have been living with.
Yes.
God is a solution bringer.
Amen.
God is the one who comes into a situation and changes.
Amen.
Everything about that situation.
Amen.
When God shows up in your life,
yes.
when you allow him to be God in your life, and you allow yourself to be a child in his hands,
Amen.
And you give it to the Lord, and you don't try to help him, you will start to see the hand of God.
Amen.
You will start to see that God is not a man to lie.
Amen.
God will do what he says he will do in your life.
Amen.
According to the word of the Lord. And beloveds, like I said, there is no situation impossible with this God.
Amen.
Today I'm going to do a continuation of a message that I shared with you on Thursday. When I finished that message, the Lord said, you are not done.
Amen.
With what I wanted to speak with my people. So God gave me a continuation of this message. He downloaded it in my spirit the same day the same night, and he said, speak my word to my people. And today I'm going to be very short and straight to the point and just give you the word of the Lord as he has given it unto me. And I pray for you that you will be able to capture this word, that you will be able to take this word with you to heart. You'll be able to table it before the Lord and say, God, given my situation, what do you want me to do?
Amen.
We are in a season, beloveds, that God is addressing the elephants in our rooms.
Amen.
The elephants in our lives.
Amen.
That we would rather pretend that they are not there, while in actual fact we know that they are the very reasons why we don't sleep at night.
Amen.
That they are the very reasons why the enemy continues to torment us, continues to have a foothold in our lives.
Amen.
And we are in a time where God is taking away the pretense. God is taking away the veil. God is taking away the facade. And God is coming to strip all of those things from your life so that he can actually start to work in your life.
Amen.
Majority of the time we pray to God to change certain things in our lives, but we are not willing to go through the process that allows for God to work.
Amen.
I need you to pray for your heart in this day, beloveds, that you may completely in this day submit your life into the hands of God.
Amen.
And not try to help God in what you want him to be a part of in your life and what you don't want him to be a part of. The very things that you've been telling yourself that you can handle by yourself, the very things that you've been keeping God out of in your life, those are the very areas that God is going to be dealing with in this season.
Amen.
That God is going to be dealing with in this time.
Amen.
God is opening up our closets and he's taking out into full display the skeletons in our closets.
Amen.
And you need to understand something. This is not to shame us. This is not to shame you, beloved. This is not to shame your neighbor. But this is for the ultimate reason of restoration.
Amen.
I need you to understand this part. We have been talking about it. We have been talking about the fullness of restoration that is coming upon the church, that is coming upon the nations, that is coming upon the globe.
Amen.
But little time do we talk about what it takes,
yes,
for that restoration to happen. What is to be restored? Restored. It means that you are being taken back to your original place. You are being taken back to your original state. And that state may be a state that in this life you have never experienced. Because what was deposited in you and your true nature was determined before you were given this earthly suit. So majority of the time, many are the things and the arrows that the enemy brings upon our lives before we can even get to that place where we are able to know and understand what God has intended for our lives in a particular time. But we are in that time where God is getting ready to restore us, where God is getting ready to introduce us, to reintroduce us to our true nature, to our true characters, to our true intended purpose for our lives.
Amen.
We are in that time,
yes, ma'am,
where God is going to be shedding his light upon all the works of men.
Amen.
And anything that is found to be the works that were done in darkness, they are coming to light.
Hallelujah.
Now I need us to be in a place of humility.
Amen.
Listen, the Lord made it very clear. He said, those that will humble themselves in this season of rebuke, in this season of exposure, in this season where I am stripping everything that covers off and I am showing what has been happening behind the scenes, those that will be able to own up to their affairs, God will restore.
Amen.
Because all God is looking for in us is repentance.
Amen.
Is humility. Amen. To say, Lord, I blundered, but forgive me, my King. Restore me.
Amen.
That is all that God is looking for. You can look at his servant David. King David was one of the men we can look to as humanity to say this man, his walk with God was not perfect. There was a time where he even killed a man because he had committed adultery with his wife.
Yes.
But he tried everything in his power to conceal this matter.
Yes.
To a point where he ended up killing a man.
Yes.
And God was watching every single thing that was happening. God was watching, and when it was done, God sent a prophet to this man. And he said, tell him what he has done. And the fact that I know about what he has done. David didn't deny it. David didn't try to use his power as king to deny what he did. But he humbled himself before God.
Yes.
And God restored David.
Amen.
There was consequences that he had to face because of what he did, but God restored him.
Amen.
We need to understand the time that we are in.
Amen.
We are in a time where God is coming with full restoration.
Amen.
So when we talk about full restoration, it means that no area in your life will be left untouched.
Amen.
I repeat myself. The fullness of restoration, it means that now he has to look into the fullness of your life. God is going to be looking into your workspace. He's going to be looking into your work in his house.
Amen.
He's going to be looking into how you interact with your spouse.
Yes.
Your works in your home. God is going to be looking into how you interact with your community. Everything that makes you who you are.
Amen.
Is coming into the forensic in intention of God to look into what you have been doing.
Amen.
God is going to be doing a forensic audit into our lives.
Amen.
And we need to be ready for that. And we need to pray for his mercies that he may help us in this time where he's going to be ushering us into the fullness of who he has intended us to be. I need us to go back to Exodus chapter 2. We're going to take our readings from Exodus chapter 2.
Amen.
And I'm going to be starting from verse 8. It says, and Pharaoh's daughter said to her, go. So the maiden went and called the child's mother. Then Pharaoh's daughter said to her, take this child away and nurse him for me. I will give you your wages. So the woman took the child and nursed him. And the child grew, and she brought him to Pharaoh's daughter. And he became her son. So she called his name Moses, saying, because I drew him out of the water. Now it came to pass in those days when Moses was grown, that he went out to his brethren and looked at their burdens. And he said, and he saw an Egyptian beating a Hebrew, one of his brethren. So he looked this way and that way. And when he saw no one, he killed the Egyptian and hid him in the sand. And when he went out the second day, behold, two Hebrew men were fighting. And he said to the one who did the wrong, why are you striking your companion? Then he said, who made you prince and judge over us? Do you intend to kill me as you killed the Egyptian? So Moses feared and said, surely this thing is known. When Pharaoh heard this matter, he sought to kill Moses. But Moses fled from the face of Pharaoh and dwelt in the land of Midian and sat down by a well.
Amen.
Bless the reading of the word of the Lord.
Amen.
Today we are going to be talking about blackmail and extortion.
Amen.
These are the two words God used. He said, talk to them about blackmail.
Yes.
The Lord said, it is not business as usual.
Amen.
So you shouldn't expect me to come here and read the scriptures for you and beat around the bush.
Amen.
Because we need every single person who logs in to hear the word of the Lord to understand exactly what God is saying. That's why he's speaking in plain language, so that we know what he's talking about and what he's saying to us in this time.
Amen.
The Lord said today we are going to be talking about blackmail.
Amen.
an extortion.
Amen.
When the Lord started to download this in my spirit, I'm just going to explain it to you and say it to you the way that he said it to me. He started to take me into the marketplace.
Yes.
And he started to show me how in today's time, majority of the people are making it in the marketplace.
Yes.
And how much it is grieving him. How much people have fallen into the traps of the enemy. Mm. And they are living their lives in fear of the enemy instead of fear for God.
Amen.
He started to take me into the church to show just how much his servants are living in fear of the things that are not known.
Amen.
The things that people might get to know about them. The mistakes that they have made. That Satan is using certain individuals to blackmail them.
Amen.
So that they can continue to do whatever ill will they want to do in the church. Because they have something on the man of God or the woman of God.
Amen.
I'm here to talk about blackmail.
Yes.
And extortion. Some of you, you have families. God took me into the household. He showed me so many married couples that are being blackmailed by their secret lovers, that are being blackmailed by somebody they had an affair with, that wants to destroy their marriage, that wants to extort them by continuously asking for things, asking for money, asking for attention, asking for all manner of things in return for keeping quiet about what they know the man has done or the woman has done.
Yes.
Against their spouse.
Yes.
And the Lord is saying this thing ends with 2021.
Amen.
This thing ends with 2021. Listen to me very carefully, beloveds. There are certain things in your life that the enemy of your soul has trapped, had laid a trap on your path.
Amen.
To fall into those things.
Yes.
Only for him to now turn around and come back as your accuser.
Mm.
And come back to torment you. And come back to tell you that you will, if this thing comes out, you will never recover.
Yes.
I am here to let you know that God is getting ready to set you free.
Amen.
From the oppression of the enemy. Listen
Amen.
To me. There's nothing. When I started this teaching, I said there is nothing that is impossible for this God.
Amen.
There is nothing that God cannot do. There is nothing that God cannot handle when we give it to him.
Come on.
Many of you today, you live in fear.
Yes.
You have no idea whether you are going to be able to go back to work tomorrow or not.
Mm-hmm.
Because for you to keep your job, you have to sleep with someone.
Yes.
For you to keep your job, somebody has to be given something.
Speak on it.
But God is saying, that is not the life I have called you to live.
Amen.
As my children.
Amen.
Listen, when the Bible says the truth shall set you free, we don't talk, God doesn't, he doesn't write things in his word.
No.
That are not true.
Yes, ma'am.
There is a solution to everything in this world, in this book called the Bible, the Holy Bible.
Yes, ma'am.
The Bible tells us that the truth shall set you free.
Amen.
On Thursday, I spoke about this. I said, Aru Twain, let's be delivered from Batubatari.
Amen.
Because Satan, oh, Jerika Batubatari.
Amen.
You live your life in fear, continuous fear, because you don't know what this person is going to want next.
Mm-hmm.
The last time they wanted 10,000, oh, Jacobo Matunisa, Omonese 10,000. You are still waiting to know what else they will say they want to keep them quiet. How long? Do you intend on living like that?
Mm.
How long do you intend on slipping your way to the top?
Yes.
How long?
Mm.
Do you intend on sleeping with that person because you don't want them to tell your spouse what you have been doing? You don't want to risk losing your marriage. How long?
Mm.
And yet you come to church. You pray to God. Even if you don't go to church, you pray still. And you say, Lord, see me through. If that has been your prayer, this is the answer from God. Let the chips fall where they may.
Amen.
But you tell those people no more.
Amen.
ala nkutlwa gore kareng kare you tell them no more
no more
ga o batla go ya go bua ya go bua
amen
I'm tired ha e le gore tiro ya gago e takatse ke lapile motho a modimo tsa tiro ya gago listen God has your blessings ready for you but Satan wants you to continue to believe that he is the only one who can give you something which always comes with a cost
amen
a cost that is too high to bear
yes.
listen if that marriage is from God it will survive
amen
do you hear me there is something about destiny let me tell you something about destiny many of you are crying and you are praying to God to enter into your God-given destinies let me tell you one of the things that will usher you into your true destiny is to allow the fullness of anything and everything that the enemy has against you out
amen
motlogale di bulele di tswe wa go tla o tsena ke phego
amen
nang go dorgare di phiri di a hupetsa
amen
Diphile ga di re tshedise sentle. Ga se gore ga re robatswe gore ga re na madi. Ga re robatswe ke gore batho ba re tshwere diphiri.
Emma.
Tsere sa itseng gore di a go tswaleng, ra go dithiba go ithellela leng. Modimo a re motho a modimo tswa ya ditlogele di beme go nna o bone gore ke tla dira jang ka botshelo jwa gago.
Amen.
Le sa go bolelwa gore the only way you can get this job is for you to do 1-2-3 with so and so. God has given you gifts that are unmatched.
Amen.
Gifts that if you are to allow him through his Holy Spirit to tap into those gifts, to know what you carry in the inside of you that is meant to feed you, that is meant to open doors for you in this world, you will see that you had wasted and squandered your time.
Yes, ma'am.
And your body and your mind. From constantly thinking how you are going to maintain the way that you have been living your life to make ends meet.
Amen.
Many of you, none of us in this world are without fault.
Yes.
Every single person has made a mistake at one point or another in their lives.
Amen.
But we serve a God.
Yes, ma'am.
Who restores.
Yes, ma'am.
We serve a God who forgives sin.
Yes,
we serve a God whom when you ask for forgiveness for your sins, he takes those sins and he throws them into the sea of forgetfulness. It means that literally God cannot recall what you
yes,
did
ma'am.
Once you give it to him.
Amen.
Man can remind you time and again, but God, the one who met us,
yes.
Once he forgives you, once he says it is forgiven, that means that heaven has no record
amen.
Of what you have done. That is why the apostle Paul said, I have wronged no man.
Amen.
And some people were offended by his statement to say, how can this man say he has not wronged any man when we know what he used to do to Christians? Exactly what he used to do before he encountered Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Which brings me to my statement today, or to the verse that I just shared with you today. When the secret that Moses had was known, when he came to a place of knowing that now it is known, and Pharaoh is after my life, and Pharaoh now is going to want to kill me. Bo Pharaoh ba masiru a lona ke bo mang? Ka go oshi. Ka se mo ba e dileng hela. Lena le bo Pharaoh le lona mo matshelong ga
le.
La ba itse. Satan will come for you.
Amen.
After he tempts you to do what you've been called to do his way. Then he comes back as your accuser.
Yes.
And starts to torment you and require your life. But we are in a time where God is saying, as he requires you and your life, I am inviting you to flee.
Yes.
To your place of encounter with me.
Yes.
A place where I will teach you.
Yes.
Who you are.
Yes.
A place where I will give you everything you need.
Yes.
In order to be able to take this thing head on.
Yes.
In order to come back with the kind of boldness that many will wonder. Is this not the same man? Is this not the same woman? Who had done 1, 2, 3, 4?
Mm-hmm.
Why? Because you've had an encounter with God.
Yes.
You now know your true identity and you refuse for your past to speak louder than your future. You refuse for your past to speak louder than your true nature. You refuse for your past to dictate who you are. Many of you people have put labels on you because of your past mistakes.
Yes.
Only God can strip those labels off of you.
Yes.
Do you hear what I'm saying?
Yes.
Only God can strip them off of you.
Yes.
Some of you people know that you have been from relationship to relationship to relationship to relationship. So they've put a label on you. And you started to believe that label. And you started to believe that you are trash. You started to believe that you are good for nothing. You started to believe that you can never amount to anything. Some of you that have been required by certain people in high places to sleep with them in order to get an opportunity. You have reduced yourself in your mind to believe that all you can offer is your body. But the devil is a lie.
Amen.
We are in a time. Yes, God is exposing every lie.
Amen.
God is in this time getting ready to renew our minds.
Amen.
I've spoken to you about the fact that we are going to see the raw power of God. You need to understand that before we see the raw power of God, there is something more powerful that God wants to do. And that is to restore your mindset.
Amen.
To restore your mindset.
Amen.
Because it doesn't matter how many miracle signs and wonders you see with your eyes, if your mind is not renewed, if you don't come into the fullness of knowledge and understanding of who you are, according to the dictates and according to that which is written about you by the Father of glory, you will constantly be cheated out of your place of inheritance by Satan to settle for less. But we're in a time where God is going to be dealing with these matters. I've spoken about certain corporations and certain systems that are coming under the judgment of God. This is one of the reasons why the judgment is coming. Because now people were taking this, the power that God had given them through their positions was being misused.
Yes.
To oppress the people.
Yes.
Was being misused to treat people in ways that are not fair. An unfair distribution also of wages and salaries.
Mm-hmm.
Something that you have worked for, now you still have to also sleep your way to get. But that rightfully belongs to you. That nonsense stops.
Amen.
We are in a time where God is dealing with these matters.
Amen.
We are in a time where God is going into our communities. And even those that are supposed to be fathers, those that are supposed to be mothers, that are involved in the ills of the nation and the society today, like rape, like child trafficking, prostitution. God is going to be dealing with these things.
Amen. Amen.
God is going to be dealing with these matters. So instead of hiding behind whatever you've been hiding behind, your positions, instead of hiding behind all manner of things that you've been hiding behind, whether you've opened foundations to make you look good, you've been given to orphans to make you look good, but you know very well that the reality is your life is rotten. Your life, if people were to know what you have been doing behind the scenes. We need God in this time, beloveds.
Amen.
Nothing will be left unturned. No table in this time will be left unturned. Hear me and hear me well. That is why God is calling us to get our houses in order before he gets it in order for us.
Mm-hmm.
It is time to get our house in order.
Amen.
It is time to go before God and ask him, Lord, I've made this mistake. I've wronged my wife. I've wronged my husband. How do I make it right? Ke la pile modimo ke mmelo o nanga le di 24/7. A mpolella gore o a bua, o tloga a bua, o tloga a letsa mosajwane, o tloga a letsa monnane, a bua, o tloga a letsa a senda dinepe. Ke a bua.
Amen.
Ke a itse re ditaba tsa tsetseng ga di a rema sentle. Gate go na le monna a re ya re topic ke gone ya repita topic ya ile re ya repita ganya bazalwana re ta tshwana ke gore re repita gane hela mme Jesu wa baka
amen
ha se na go bakanya ga o sa thola o pita gana
amen
wa go phuthuloga so wa go bona re so se ga se setona ka ha ne satana se dira setona ka teretsa motho ga ile motho a gago ke sa rene gore le tswelele le dira jang because you will be also asking God to deliver you from that spirit
yes
of lust of fornication or whatever it is that you are being blackmailed about when God delivers you you need to understand and have faith in God true faith in God it means that I'm willing to trust his instructions even though I know that this thing it can go this way or that way
amen
but I'm willing to trust God and pray that he will be able to restore my house
amen
ha go tsa go tsenwa ha ke ngwana ngwana hela wa maba na go tsenya ha a go balela di nepe di atswa ha o sa tsisa ha o sa iwa le 2000 di nepe ke a di tsenya ke na le number ya mosadi wa go mo ro di tsenye monna ke lapile tsenya di nepe tseo a re ga ta go tsidiswa yana re tsidisa jana ka go tse leng gore God is there to help us out of
yes
If you've been living a life of corruption, getting tenders by corruption, you are tired of bribing people. Tell them I'm tired. Halisa di nele ga gore sepe and seek this God and you will know him to be faithful and true.
Amen.
Because here's the thing, what belongs to you that God gets ready to give you, your inheritance cannot be challenged. Nothing in this world can keep your inheritance from reaching you. And that is one of the things the enemy doesn't want you to know. So whatever belongs to you, no one and nothing can keep it from you.
Amen.
Do you understand what I'm saying?
Amen.
You need to know these things to be free, to be set free in your mind, to be set free in your heart. Some of you, you don't even know what you have become because you are bitter. Ya gore o nna o tshugile hela gore o nna o khoberwa ke dilo mo phone o tshugile o khadimola bana how you are no longer yourself why because you have allowed the enemy to put you here a go tseng o go tsentse mo letso go satan a go putela hela go putela to a place and to a point where you no longer recognize yourself But your life is worth so much more.
Amen.
It's time to stand and be bold.
Amen.
And say, let the chips fall where they may.
Yes.
But I trust my God to restore me.
Amen.
I trust him to restore my integrity.
Amen.
I trust him to restore my image. When it's all said and done, I trust him to restore me.
Amen.
God restores. Listen, Mokoninya, God restores. He's all powerful.
Amen.
God can make sure that someone who has written off yesterday, tomorrow they are sought after by every single person.
Amen.
The problem is we don't know him. If we knew him, we would understand nothing in this world is too hard for this God to handle.
Amen.
Nothing in this world is too hard for him to deliver us out of.
Amen.
Ha le go rutso re ke sa di direkso la bi. Wa ba kolota da threatening you see God I'm telling you there is like I said there's no area that he's not touching in this time
amen
ha le gore monna yo o robala le nne ka gore o duella rente ke ena duella nkoloi ke ena duella ndijo o tsaba gore hela o ka re nya wa go se ke a duella rente sisi phutha dilwana we kwa mmago
amen
o go itsolopanya o la beng we emele modimo a bua le wena a go bontsetsela
amen
gore o ka itsidisa jang ka gore monna ga a tshwana gore nne ena tla go tsidisa modimo go netse go ka ga o ka itsidisa ka teng go moteng ga gago
amen
go batla hela gore o simolle go rapela o lebe Jehova o mmotse gore modimo nna o netseng se nka itsidisa ka sone
amen
gore le reo le ata mo botshelong jwa gago ebe le o leng gore le ditsala modimo wa le kopanya gore le tswelele le dire sengwe mmogo e seng gore o nna le ene hela ka gore wa go duela rente ga wa tshwanela go tshela jalo modimo ga go biletsa go tshela jalo
amen
ga wa biletsa rente ga wa biletsa dijo ga wa biletsa nandosi Kawa biletsa debonese pizza Kawabile tswa dinepe tsa Instagram.
Amen.
You've been called to a full life.
Amen.
With purpose. And God is ready to give it to you. But you need to be able to let go.
Amen.
Of anything that is a hindrance from that which God wants to do for you. And don't even think about your friends and what they will think. They are also confused.
Amen.
Alone in their bed, they wonder. There are some things they fear. There are some insecurities they have. But during the day, we all put a front. We all put a facade. Then you get out there and you will be convinced people have it together. They don't. They also need solutions. They need direction from God. But they will make it look like they have it together. You owe it to yourself. You owe it to your generation to allow God to bring out the fullness of who you are. Moses had to flee from Pharaoh. Moses had to go. He had tried to live and do what he had been called to do with his own effort, and he failed dismally and got himself in trouble. Some of you, you genuinely have a passion and you want to pursue this passion, but the way you are going about it is not the godly way. And God is saying, come to your place of encounter with me.
Amen.
Where I will give you the fullness of what you need to be able to execute what I've called you to do. God cannot give you an assignment and a mission and not make a way and not provide for that which he's asking you to do.
Amen.
That would be an unfair thing and an unfair deal. And because every single one of us, we are called to do something in this world. We are set in this place with a mission and an assignment. That means there is a portion of resources that is specially reserved for you.
Amen.
But there's a place to get everything you need. When Moses finally left Egypt, immediately when he entered that place, Midian, he started to have encounter after encounter. He met his wife. He met his father-in-law. They welcomed him. He was meeting his destiny connects, because his father-in-law was not just a father-in-law. He became one of the men that advised Moses according to the counsel of God.
Amen.
And then the most epic of the encounters he had was with God himself while he was tending to the flock of his father-in-law.
Amen.
Stop trying to make it happen by yourself. Mudima rilela bi halala ba arilela bi arilela bi.
Amen.
Jano dinele mudim.
Yes.
Dinele mudimo hela di monela gore mudimo ke likile ke lapile. Nthusa gore tsela ke tsefe. Ha le gore ke sontse gore ke na meke emetse hale ke tlogele 1 2 3. Ha le gore netana o tlhokana le gore o rekise kolo yeo to make ends meet for now. So that, listen, material is, my goodness, material is nothing. It comes and goes. And when you are called to something, you can always recover it.
Amen.
Have you not heard of people who have been billionaires and then they lost everything? And then a few years later, they are bigger and better than before. Why?
Amen.
Because it's in the inside of you. Don't be afraid to lose material things for a good cause, because God will restore them and even better than what you had before. So if it's deliverance that you need, it's from people's thoughts and opinions. Today, I pray that God will help you.
Amen.
To be delivered from batubatari in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
That you will start to live a life of purpose and focus and gaze your eyes on the one who matters.
Amen.
Jesus Christ himself.
Amen.
The author and the finisher of your faith. How is it to my friends and my friends? They are not the authors and the finishers of your faith. Or your small house that has been tormenting your family. That is not the author and the finisher. Was she there or was he there when you began what you began with your spouse?
Yeah,
and that's surely not going to be there at the end of it.
Yes,
it is time for men, the kind of men that God is calling forth in this time. They are fathers.
Amen.
They are the kind of men that we can be happy to have in our community.
to teach the young boys that are coming after them what it means to be a man.
Amen.
And one of the things that can mark you as a man is the ability to face head on your mistakes.
Amen.
And you will see God coming through for you.
Amen.
You will see God restore for you what you were afraid you were going to lose.
Yes.
Because He's a faithful God.
Amen.
You will see and you will start to experience your marriage the way that God has intended. There is the kind of marriage that God... You see, marriage is a thing that comes from God.
Yes.
We need to understand that. But because today we have so much modernized marriage and have left God out of marriage, it has become a burden instead of a blessing.
Yes.
But marriage is such a beautiful blessing from God.
Amen.
And it's something that if you are to submit to God so that He can start to work it out and remove Satan's fingerprints all over it.
Yes.
And He starts to teach both of you, your wife and you as a husband, what your functions are and how you are to complement one another.
Yes.
You will grow old together.
Amen.
You will have no desire for other people.
Amen.
You will know that this is my... Because now you have higher understanding of what connects you other than your physical appearance or whatever it is that might have attracted you that is considered carnal. It goes beyond those things. And those secret things can only be revealed by God that will make you become one with your spouse in a way that nothing will be able to come and be able to break that which God has brought together.
Amen.
We are in a time of full restoration, beloveds. Allow God to restore your life. Allow God to restore your business. Allow God to restore you in your workplace. Allow God to restore your marriage. Allow God to restore you in His house.
Amen.
He spoke to me as well about ministers that are being blackmailed. Can you imagine? In church. People, where do you get, I was going to use a word that I probably shouldn't be using. Where do you get the audacity to? Wait, you gotta.
Amen.
Listen. It doesn't matter what that man or woman of God has done that you believe you know about them. Many ministers today, God was showing me, they are being blackmailed. I'm not here to defend anything that might have been done in churches. That is not okay. I'm not here to defend that. But I will say, God said, my servants, leave them to me.
Yes.
Because God judges everyone, especially His servants. I will deal with them.
Yes.
Leave them to me. But when you start to do that, you are crossing into a place you shouldn't even attempt to cross into. It is way above your pay grade. Don't do it. Don't do it. Don't do it. Lahasatanaka hotem tayang. Don't do it. Let God deal with it. God, I said in this time, nothing will be left unturned. So God will deal with it. If indeed they have done certain things in the church that are not supposed to do, God will deal with it.
Amen.
You, your business is to pray for them. Because at the end of the day, we want the church to be restored.
Amen.
The reason why we keep losing our battle with Satan is because the church is scattered. We are busy pointing fingers at one another. But whenever a man has erred, our business is to pray so that they can be restored. Because here's the thing. As your coverings, they are, if they fall, then it's going to cost you something as well.
Yes.
Because you are one body. Can you imagine the Nathan? That doesn't make sense. That it doesn't make sense.
Yes.
But that's what we are doing. And God is saying it comes to a stop. And I pray for servants of God as well, that you will be able to be bold enough to stand before the people where you have blundered and say, my people, le ka intshwarela, ha ke ntse ke ja era.
Amen.
Go ntse go ntse jana le jana le jana. Ga ke tsho re Satane o re diripile ha kae. Mehela, this is the case and God will restore.
Amen.
And here's the thing, those that were meant to walk with you.
Yes.
God has already prepared the hearts.
Amen.
And God already knows that nothing will shake them.
Amen.
From walking with you. Think about David. David blundered so many times, but there were men that were so faithful to David, the mighty men of David. They were with him all the time.
Amen.
Even though there was a time he le gore ya no maithela basadi ba bone ba go batile go senyega mo, but God restored.
Amen.
They continued. A ke ra gona ntwe sa neng.
Amen.
E ne go eta go nna nyana. Ba riana nyana no e bona go mpeno re khomile go sele basadi ba rona ba tana.
Amen.
Bo ka re go a senyega. David encouraged himself and then the Lord restored.
Amen.
Such is life. We all make mistakes at one point or another, but we have a God that restores.
Amen.
And we are in a season where he wants to restore every single one of you and every single one of us, and we need to allow him to do that. Don't allow anyone to make you feel ashamed when God starts to deal with you.
Amen.
When God starts to deal with your life, because it's only a matter, even how come about how it's only a matter of time before God starts dealing with them.
Amen.
Because God hates a haughty play, a haughty look.
Yes.
Anyone who starts to laugh at someone God is dealing with, you are provoking God to turn to you and to start dealing with you. So we are in a time where we need to be mature enough to allow God to restore our homes.
Amen.
To restore the church.
Amen.
To restore the workplace. Gore bana ba rona ga ba ya go bata ditiro, be re itse gore bana ba rona ba safe. They are not going to be asked to provide more than their qualifications. God is restoring in this time, beloveds.
Amen.
Let's allow him to be God in our lives. I do pray for you that you were blessed by this message. This will be our last Sunday service this year, 2021. I'm going to be going into a time of spending time with God, intimate time with God, for him to give me the fullness of what he has in store for us during the three-day meeting of the 29th to the 31st of December 2021, as he begins to give us instructions for 2022 going forward.
Amen.
And he's been speaking to me about the next coming 9 years and how crucial that 9 years is. And, you know, some of the things that he's been highlighting to me, I find them so extraordinary. So I pray for you that every video that we've shared with you so far, because it's speaking into what's coming. It is not past. It's speaking into what is coming. That you may take time to go to every prophetic word that we have been relaying with you in this season. We are going to be giving you snippets of the different things that God is highlighting from the messages that we have already shared with you thus far, leading to the three-day meeting. And we hope that you will be encouraged and that your spirit man will help you to recall what God has been saying and what God is getting ready to do. That you may also be encouraged in your spirit man and to know personally what it means for you. So I thank you. And I thank you for your time. God bless you. Have a beautiful, beautiful time during these holidays. May you enjoy it with your families. And may you allow the chips to fall where they may. And come clean with your loved ones. That God may begin to restore you. That 2022 may be the beginning of a clean foundation as Jesus Christ, your Lord and your Savior, as the foundation of whatever it is that you're going to be doing. God bless you and God keep you.
Amen. Yeah.